All right, and we're recording. Hey gang, Andy here, and I just wanted to give you a quick update on the types of content you can expect from this channel as well as my others. I didn't really get into specifics as far as what to expect. I just kind of said, hey, you know, Navy stuff goes here and editing stuff goes here. I didn't really get into the nitty gritty, but now that I have everything up on the screen here, I can kind of go through it one by one. So I have a couple unboxings that I did throughout the year that I just didn't get around to editing. So I didn't buy all the stuff at once. I didn't come to a whole bunch of money. It was just kind of a over time sort of thing. So I got my Samsung Galaxy phone unboxing, my Samsung Gear S2, it's my watch, my smartwatch. Got the unboxing for that, as well as the NVIDIA Shield TV, which is a little media streaming device. I also have a new apartment tour from when I first moved in, so there was like nothing in the apartment at all. So it's an empty apartment tour. And then later on, I'm gonna be doing the filled out apartment tour when I got all my stuff over here. I also have a couple tests of the Rode VideoMic Me. There were some kids playing some music at Western, so I decided to record them just to test out to see how good the mic sounded in slightly louder environments. I also got a lost vlog that I wanna kinda chop up a little bit. But in more recent stuff, I have a new episode of Andy Talks Navy where I do a reaction to the Battle Stations video. But the most recent thing that I recorded from last night was the Simple Plan concert from Grand Rapids. Y'all told me to get out of the house, so I did. But no, I did that at my own volition. I saw they were coming out to Grand Rapids, bought some tickets. It's their 15-year anniversary of the No Pads album. And they did the whole thing, top to bottom, and did a couple extra songs at the end too. It's like, I didn't realize how long the concert would be. I figured, you know, since it was a pop punk band, it would just last like maybe an hour tops, but it went like nearly two. So it was like, whoa. In addition to the Simple Plan concert, which I gotta admit right now, it's a little rough at first because at first I was using my Sony CX430V, this camcorder right here. Then I had my Zoom H1 attached to the bottom, but I only got like two or three songs in till one of the bouncers was like, you know, cut that shit out. So I decided to switch to my smartphone, which, you know, I always find that ironic whenever I go to concerts with a actual camera, and bouncers would kind of look at me funny and be like, what the fuck are you doing? Like, get the fuck out, or just stop the camera or whatever. But meanwhile, it was like all these girls and stuff, like cell phones out, like, oh my God. So I recorded the rest of the concert on my cell phone, but I hadn't prepared to record on my cell phone. So my memory card filled up really quickly and I had to change to internal storage, like in the middle of one of the songs. But after that point, it went pretty well. There's some crowd surfing moments where I nearly got bonked on the head. So there's a couple dodgy camera shakes and stuff every once in a while. But for the most part, it went pretty okay. And the sound quality, I never recorded a concert with the Galaxy phone before, so I didn't know how it was gonna turn out, but I figured that there might be a slim chance it might turn out okay. And from some of the clips that I'm hearing, I mean, it clips a little bit, but I'm gonna do my best to kind of smooth it out as best I can. I mean, it is cell phone footage, so it's not gonna be the best, but I'm gonna do what I can. But in addition to that, I also have an unboxing of my Fool Telematic Telecaster copy. One of my friends who runs the Fool Audio Research Company sent me a free copy. That's thanks for helping him out. But the last thing I wanna talk to you guys about, the next Day of the Swan. So as you guys know, I'm a big fan of the late great Roger Swan, and earlier this year, I remastered his Tokyo Swan series of videos to coincide with the 7-year anniversary of his passing. For this coming September, I want to do another Day of the Swan where I upload like old episodes from him, but this time it's going to be Iwate Swan, so it's not going to be quite as much as Tokyo Swan. I'm going to upload those on September 11th, 2017, and the reason for that is it's going to coincide with the 10-year anniversary of Roger Swan's first arrival to Tokyo to start up the Tokyo Swan series. That's what's going to be coming out for my channels. Hope you guys tune into the videos. And with that said, this is the Andy-san. Signing off for now. And as always, we'll see you next time. Catch you later, guys. Bye.